My favorite literature in the Serbian language is made by Dragoslav Mihailović, the Serbian writer who was doing many good novels, and one of them was dealing with the famous history of people of Balkans, famous history that relates to Infobiro, which was Tito's concentration camp in the name of fighting Russians, separating with Stalin and putting in this concentration camp about 12 or 14,000 people living in incredible conditions. This mythology was never introduced to the West like any other mythology, frankly. So special difficulty when you start thinking, you very often have designers of the future, of young directors who are always thinking, what will be the reaction from the West? They basically make first mistake by thinking like this, because West anyway does not respond to our mythology. One of the mythologies that was very cruel and awful was the Infobiro one, the one that I just mentioned. And this very project was initiated by a poetic, political need to do the project, speaking about 48 and 50. Unlike many others who wanted to create a political mythology out of this, I thought again that family, if it's centered in the middle of the attention, and then whatever period, including the period of difficulty that people had with Tito splitting with Stalin, and those who yesterday were screaming long live Stalin, today were supposed to say kill Stalin. In this change, there were many dramatic stories and many families who were not even too much political were affected by this. And I created a story about a family that was affected by somebody who was not political but was in the package. So again, it's like outsider, innocent father of the family, innocent in a political way, not innocent because he was having an affair with the other woman who was basically doing all this to him, and which created this family drama. So in this very film, I was trying to be individual in the sense of main hero, young boy who sees the family going through the very dramatic period, and at the same time I was describing, by the way, the idea of this very critical point of Yugoslav history. But never putting too much weight on the history, always trying to see the history and what happened in the family through the eyes of 6 years old boy. Through his eyes, moral questions and many others that I opened in this film were much stronger. And when the film was loved by jury members of Cannes Film Festival in many countries where the film was screened, nobody was understanding what this Infobiro is. They were just taking part of this mythology that somebody who was a communist could have been accused even if he was not guilty. Which is not just a communist specialty, it's a worldwide known thing. So why I'm mentioning this, when the young Slav director wants to be introduced in the West, he always thinks in the terms how the West will recognize it, which is absolutely wrong, because you get recognized by your own vision of the world. And difficulty when you're coming from this place is that you have to each time to create mythology about this, because they don't recognize it. They don't know. When somebody who is known in the West is creating his movie, he relies always on the mythology that is introduced to the Western audience. When you come from here, you bring your own mythology. You have to create it. This is why it's very difficult. But this film confirmed to me, if your interest is to extend and to project your emotional reaction to the life through the eyes of young boy, even history could be understood or could be accepted if not understood. So if the emotion as a primary reaction to the life is exposed properly in your film, everywhere in the world people could recognize what is the drama of the young boy from Sarajevo. or any village in this area. In the last movie, there is a certain, if not what happened in my family, is very close to what would happen if it happened. So conditionally speaking, almost every film I deeply had taken as my story. So if in, I don't know, Time of the Gypsies was gypsy history that is not affecting very much me, from the middle of the process I started feeling like this young hero. So in every hero, including father, when father was away in business, I am in it, I am inside. Especially because in the area where there's political events, when these big tragedies were affecting families, I was very close. If not always what actually happened to me, I was close to the families where this mythology was circling around and was very well introduced to it, which is, in fact, the cinema of the what one guy called open veins, which means cinema that is a cinema coming from the deepest reaction from the author who is doing it, which is today something people don't recognize because people are not in the position to ask for cinema that gives them such a, I would call, strong reaction to the world. Every film that I was doing is almost the same movie. The question is just in the different phases, different formal approach was introduced to the audience. It's like all your life trying to solve the question of a painter who is thinking if the sketch that he did in the beginning was better than the final film he did. In between these two extremes, I was trying to put my cinema. Never to be so precise and so strict and defined by the genre of the film, but never to lose this kind of lousy beauty that sketch of painting has in the beginning. So in every film I'm putting many motifs that remind the previous one, but not because I don't have ideas, but it's because I am very sticking to the past, and I'm just I like to see again what I loved previously and what is one of the motifs that inspire me all my life. So this film I could consider as the most realistic, novel-like, European tradition of Slav cinema, or European tradition of any European cinema, which is outcome of my long period of thinking, working, reading, and trying to introduce the trouble area that I come from through the eyes of a young boy, not just the West, rest of the world. Being careful enough, having a good school behind me, that any spicy element that you put into your kitchen that comes strictly from the area, it could be a little bit tiring for the people if you do not play always on a very universal level that you could communicate in every second, which brings us back to the roots of cinema. You know, if you take your cinema as a constant change, as a circus that everybody understands, you don't have to be too general, too outside of your world, but you never have to be too much in the world of the specifics of the territory where you come from. And when you put all this together, then you have a chance to communicate with the rest of the world. I'm speaking about this because when father was away in the business, is the most realistic, the most, I would say, in the tradition of realistic cinema of Europe, in which new realist elements you could find in it, but you could also find my trying to be as elegant as Jean Renoir, or as I would say effective, as funny as many Russian directors. When I discovered cinema in my first film that I made on 35 millimeter, which was called Guernica, it's a story about Jewish family affected by Nazi period, and the boy stays alone, and he discovers that his family members, based on the information of the father, have a big nose, so he starts cutting the noses, and then he gets afraid and he distracts the photos, and then he wants to make his own Guernica, remembering real Guernica. Good sujet and a good story, but most important thing that happened in my school was that I discovered the depth and the space, and how camera is suggesting, not just by what people act in front of the lens, but how the space affects the emotional life of the audience. Discovering this, I have introduced myself to incredible world of space as abstract world. Because you have a foreground, midground, and background. How do you affect the subconsciousness of the audience by introducing all of this constantly? Then, when you discover this, then you see the enormous area that you have to drag audience in. And then it became very difficult to control me, because this is very expensive. You know that most of the realistic stories in 70s and 80s, they put long lens, you have a close-ups of big stars, and then they don't need a lot of space behind. But step by step, they came back to this origin of cinema, which is again time and the space. And if the space is not treated and defined properly, the movie cannot be good. Good in a sense how cinema is defined as a major question of time and space. But as much as the people became aware of this, you call roller coaster, kind of incredible ups and downs, positions that people go from in the day-by-day life, it wouldn't be as successful as it was. But I think the specialty is that I'm deeply into the mentality of the people that I come from here. But why this was supposed to be and could have been recognized by the rest of the world? Because we are going through many festivities, many carnivalistic moments, many things that in general you recognize as one of those who also other people go through, or at least they could communicate through this to the mentality. If this was just, if it was not framed in this collective subconsciousness that I follow all the time, that I didn't recognize as a specialty of people here, these switches, this intensive exchange of sadness, sorrow, and excitement wouldn't be standing on its own legs, and then it wouldn't be organic, and then nobody could believe it. So I think this is this was introduced in when father was away on the business, I think in the best way, because throughout the eyes of the boy, you see the world of adults with the moral and other degenerated processes made by history, made by politics, but also very often we are introduced to this kind of collective festivity level of life that is quite funny and quite exciting on the general level. Once I've learned in the school, I didn't learn, I've seen it. Once you have two people talking, and there is a window, and there is a cat coming and trying to eat the sweet, or to eat anything there, and one moment the conversation is introduced to the certain, or taken to the very emotional way, the look of the cat on the window and the confrontation of these two bring the essence of cinema. Once I learned this, I never stopped confronting the worlds, the contradicting worlds of what could be strengthening one way of talking or confronting. I never stopped doing it. And I think this comes from the deepest, I would say, deepest roots of the tradition of the people here. And this kind of complementary world of different things happening at the same time, which is very familiar to cinema. It's a parallel act, main layer and many others. But people don't believe, this is industry's limit, that you could drag people into the world of doing so many things because they're afraid of losing the audience. This is the only thing they think, and then they're limited by it. It's very difficult to have a kid who is the main hero of the movie, who has to be a non-professional. So the world of adults you could describe as the world of something in between the stereotype and something that could really good actors could bring to your cinema. So again, confrontation. It's like always thinking in the biblical levels of thinking, day and night, hot and cold, to have always this very inner hidden agenda of dynamic world of people who you see by being confronted constantly, not just on the level of the scenes, but also by the very substance that you have in your hands that you want to turn into your cinema. Non-professionals, day and night, two people talking, the third distracting, always introducing the world of many things happening at the same time. But you cannot do it just like a mechanic order. You have to be your own, you have to be excited by this thing in order to excite people. If you are not, you don't get it. I think this is mainly by my knowledge and my emotion that I wanted to translate into my cinema, in which I have deep belief that there is still a very strong connection in between individual and collectiveness around. This is my, if this even doesn't happen, my belief is so strong that I have always think in the terms, when I see our men drunk with a tie that is untied and put on the left side, I always know why this happened, and why and how is this connected to the rest of the community that he belongs to. This is like in the last century, when the connection between collectivity and individuality exists, I always explored and enjoyed this kind of craziness that collectivity here brings in front of your eyes.